Hello and welcome to Old Ways Gardening and Prepping. My name is Teresa. I'd like to welcome you into my backyard in my main herb garden here where I'm sitting just in front of my sweetgrass bed. Yes, I grow sweetgrass. It is an amazing sacred plant to my people and to many other Native American tribes here in America, or the Americas. Now, it likes a good, moist, fertile soil, and here in the South, it's doing better in a shaded area that gets a little morning sun and a little afternoon sun, but during the day, it's in the shade. Now, let me bring the camera down. And let me tell you, it smells absolutely amazing. I've been needing to harvest it for a while. I'll be able to get 2 harvests a year. Not only is it a sacred plant to my people, it's called the hair of the mother, or hair of Mother Earth. It's used in smudging and to make baskets and mats and to stuff pillows. Now in Europe, it grows in Europe as well. They use it for culinary seasonings, and there's a certain Polish liquor that they use sweetgrass to flavor it. And I'll have more information in the description box below. Now, a lot of people also don't know it's a medicinal. If taken in small amounts, it is amazing for cough, flus, chest congestion, pneumonia, and so on. As a tea, you can also use it as a fumatory where you breathe in the smoke and it'll help with lung problems as well. And of course, I'll have more information in the description box below. Now, I've already gave my offering so that I can harvest some of my sweetgrass. I have a whole lot more back this way as well, and I'm gonna have to build another raised bed because it has started to escape, which it is a grass, so it will. And Jilly, thank you for my scissors because I couldn't find my other ones. So you want to gently gather it. Snip it close to the ground, and like I said, it's a grass, it'll grow back. And I use not only the already dried leaves, but the green leaves. And the smell is amazing. It's also known in some places as vanilla grass, buffalo grass, which I think is a different one, but it's an amazing, amazing plant. And I need to harvest enough to make a braid and also have some for a smudge I need to make. And that's it. It gets... Oh, where'd you go? Come on. Come on. And you do not want to waste any. Make sure that you get it all. Whatever you clip, make sure you get. And a lot of people don't know that the stems close to the ground are round and hollow. And it smells so good. And of course, the scent becomes stronger as it dries as well. And it will hold its scent for many, many years. And like I said, I'm gonna come back out and harvest a whole lot more. But at this time, I just want enough to make a braid and a smudge mix. course, I'm going to come back, water it very well, and once I harvest from the big patch, I will fertilize it real good so it'll grow. But look how beautiful that is. And sweetgrass can get up to 2 foot long. It has fallen over here because of the ungodly heat we have been having, but it is still thriving and growing very well. You just have to have it in the perfect spot. It smells so amazing. I absolutely love sweetgrass. Okay, I have enough for now. And I will bring you back underneath the canopy so that we can make a braid of it. And I'll bring you back here in just a bit. Okay, we're back up under the canopy. I apologize, y'all. I'm going to have to talk over a police helicopter because apparently some thug, gangster, or something has done something and the police are looking for him. But I'm going to finish this video with the hell of hot water. Okay, so I have my sweetgrass here. And I want to make sure that I have green leaves for the sweetgrass braid. I've got all my dried leaves in here, which I will cut up and use for my smudge mix. Set that there. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep working on building my sweetgrass braid. I hope they catch the thug. People have to learn that you have to be law-abiding citizens. No, y'all don't worry about me one bit. I'm perfectly fine. If somebody decides to come up here and try to start some trouble, they're going to wish they hadn't. I just apologize for the noise in the background because I'd rather y'all be listening to wind chimes and birds singing, not the bird flying up in the air. And like I was saying, sweetgrass has many medicinal properties. And of course, used in moderation, it is extremely good as a tea. Colds, bronchitis, pneumonia, chest congestion. And it is used in many herbal tea mixes for those same ailments. Of course, I'm going to go back through. Through the dead pieces. Nothing wrong with the drying pieces of the sweetgrass. Nothing wrong with the drying pieces of sweetgrass. I just want the braid to look beautiful that I'm giving as a gift for a house protection. And one should always, when handling sacred objects, take pride in their work. Wrapping it tightly around to secure the end. And once it dries, it won't go anywhere. Thank you. going to try to gently separate it. Into 3 seconds, as equal as possible. Start braiding, and you want to try to keep your braid as flat as possible. You notice the strand that I used to secure the top, I ended bringing it down and adding it into the braid, and it will keep it secure. Pieces like that that pop out, try to put them in securely into the braid. It takes time, but after a while, you will get used to doing it. Take your time, and you want to make sure that your braid is nice and secure and it looks good as well. And of course, when you get done, you'll straighten the braid out, flatten it out, inevitably there'll be little bitty ends that pop up or stick out. You can trim those. And you just want to make sure that any pieces, little pieces that break while you're braiding, you don't lose them and they don't hit the ground. Try to keep the braids as tight as possible because they will shrink some as they dry. And you're just going to keep braiding. Okay, had to calm Arlo down, so we're going to keep on braiding. We're going to keep braiding till we get to the very tip. This is where it gets a little more tedious because you have to make sure that you keep all those little ends in if possible. If not, I will trim them off. Like I said, it's going to pucker while you braid it, but that's okay. Because you'll be able to flatten it back out. Okay, now I'm to the end. You want to make sure you keep everything as tight as possible. out, and to make it look pretty. We have one homegrown, organic grown sweetgrass braid, and I'm not gonna, I can't tell you how wonderful it smells. And I'm gonna hang it up. Now the rest, some of it I'm going to bundle up and let it dry. Some of it I'm going to cut up so I can have small pieces to add to a smudge mix. I hope you've enjoyed this video, minus the, you know, police helicopter steadily flying over. I guess they haven't caught the thug yet, but I'd be darned if I'm going to let something like this stop me from doing what I'm needing to get done today. Simple, easy, anybody can grow sweetgrass as long as you have the right area to grow it in. And here in the South, you definitely want to grow it in mostly shade. Like I said, it gets morning sun and a little bit of evening sun, but the rest of the really hottest part of the day, it's in the shade. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and it encourages you as well to grow your own sweetgrass. It's a wonderful medicinal, it's a wonderful humidory, and it's one of many Native American tribes' sacred plants. I look forward to seeing you in my next video. Maybe it'll be a whole lot less eventful. Everyone, stay safe, stay sound, keep your head on a swivel, continue to stock your pantries, and keep your little friend even closer to you. I look forward to seeing you in my next video, and may you each be blessed. I'll see you soon. Take care.